Welcome, folks. This is Tom O'Brien of TFNN. We go 5 days a week. We go 10 hours a day. We go 24 hours a day on the internet at TFNN.com. Always remember, folks, whatever you think about, you bring about. Whatever you focus on grows. Hope everyone's having a great day, safe day. Let's make it a great week, folks. Don't make assumptions. Learn to ask questions. It's always better to ask questions than to make an assumption. Have the courage to ask questions until you're as clear as you can be. Once you hear the answer to the questions, you won't have to make the assumption because you'll know the truth. If they tell you the truth, right? Market-wise, let's take a look at it out here. We have the Dow Industrials down 139, NASDAQ off 26, S&P's down 9, gold contract up $10.70, trading at $15.10 an ounce. Silver down 41 cents, $17.98 an ounce. Light sweet crude up $7.58, $62.42 a barrel. Notes and bonds. You get the 10-year up 16 ticks, 129.03. 30-year up a full point and a half at 159.02. And King Dollar. King Dollar up 320 ticks, trading 98.150. The euro is at 110. The yen is at 108. And the pound is at 124 to 1 U.S. dollar. Our phone number is 877-927-6648. Give us a call, folks. Want to know what's going on in your world. And the world of the S&Ps, let's take a look at them. What do you have? Okay, so you get the Saudi fields getting attacked. Bottom line, market shakes it off. Oil goes up $7. It's up $10 first. Pulls back $5, up $10. S&Ps just shake the whole thing off like fast and furious. No two ways about that. So what do we have out here today? You got a lower market. You get 39 million shares traded. Guess what? That's anemic volume on the way down. That's telling me that the highs of last week are going to get tested once again, which is the 302.46. And right now, you're at 305. NDX 100, same type of setup inside the NDX. You take a look at this NDX. NDX, no sellers out here today. 15 million shares traded. That's anemic volume. We certainly had anemic volume when we try to get by the August 1st level also. But guess what? When you pull back with volume like this, this is saying this thing does not want to go lower at this particular point. You're going to spike higher once again. Notes and bonds. Now, this is where this thing's going to get a little bit tricky. But it looks to me that also the note and bond market, okay, bottom line, are not done going down on price, up on yield. We have a bounce out here today. The 10-year is up 17 ticks. You got 1.3 million contracts traded. Okay, so let's go over this. So what we had is this. You came off the highs. Well, first off, you're up 5 months in a row. Bang, okay? Went from 123 all the way up to 132 on the 10-year. We came down on volume. It hasn't finished its ABC structure on the way down yet. We have a high volume low laying out here at 128.16. That's saying it's going to get tested. Today, the volume's anemic. You got 1.3 million inside of the 10-year. Now, when we came down, we were also coming down into the breakout area of August 1st with tremendously lighter volume. It has a big expansion, there's no doubt about that. We did 2.6 million on Thursday. We did 2.4 on Friday, except what you're going into is 3.2, the breakout area. So my take is that that's not done yet. And yes, that is about as deviant as you can get. This market right now is really cool, how the different indices, okay, look to me like they all get bounces, because if you were a fundamentalist, you'd think that bottom line is that, hey, listen, man, market should be down. You got oil fields getting bombed. It's not going to be the end of this. It's probably the beginning of it. 30-year. 30-year is up a full point and a half. You've done 281,000 contracts, same type of setup, meaning that we came down on volume. You're going up on light volume today. It's never a good indication. 30-year, we had hit 157.17. We're at 159. That also is going to get tested. Gold contract. I don't think gold is done, basically coming down also. We have out here today, gold got a bid, $10.50, no doubt. 333,000 contracts. Now, what gold has done is this. It's coming into its breakout area with tremendously lighter volume. There's no doubt about that, okay? Bottom line is that Thursday, it spiked up to 15.3220. It couldn't hold price. It come back down on Friday with only 364,000 contracts, light contract volume. That being said, what's happening now is that we're coming into the downdraft that had been created out there on the September 5th. Well, the high of September 5th is 1561. The low is 1514. We did 603,000 contracts. Bottom line is that you're coming into that with much lighter volume. This is things going to have to build cars for a period of time in order to get up into and over the last highs. My take is that, yeah, we're still going to 1795, but guess what? This is not done. And this is just deviant enough, too, in the marketplace in general. Let's go to the oil market. We take a look at oil. So the Saudis, bottom line, they got attacked. It takes oil up to 63.38. You have 1.3 million contracts traded. Bottom line is that this doesn't do anything to the contract until it gets over 63.87. What's really unusual about this is that the swing point is 63.87. When you have a wide price spread accelerated volume like we do today, this thing should have been able to hit it, and it hasn't been able to hit it. If we go take a look at the XLE, which is the oil and gas equities, what you're going to see inside the XLE has volume behind the move today. Small, well, it's a good ABC up. The B point is 61.80. The A is 55, so you get $6, which gets you a price projection of 65. Right now, you're at 63. Your swing point up there is 64, 66. I expect it's going to get there. We look at ExxonMobil. ExxonMobil right now. ExxonMobil up $1.50. Check this out. This is pretty sick. So it's coming into 17 million shares, and it's only done 14.5. Chevron, that's showing an Exxon, it just doesn't have the strength. Chevron, same setup. It's this market, this is phenomenal, actually. So you're up $3.25. You got 7 million shares traded, but guess what? You're coming at the 7 million. It's not impressive what those oil stocks are actually doing out here. Our phone number is 877-927-6648. You stay right there, folks. We got our man, Mr. Steve Rhodes, coming up next. Dow Industrials down 114. NASDAQ off 17. S&P's off 6.5. We'll come right back.